10 class today. Let's just play around with P series and talk about the Riemann hypothesis. This is where things get interesting. I did show you the Basel problem the other day. I spelled it wrong. It's actually B-A-S-E-L instead of A-L. Euler, again, that was solved by Euler, or just Euler, figured out that this equals pi squared over 6, shockingly, okay? Newton couldn't do it. Leibniz couldn't do it. The Bernoulli brothers couldn't do it. It took Euler to do it, to figure out that was pi squared over 6, and that was a shocking thing. Nobody expected pi to be involved. Euler also generalized this to figuring out what this summation is, for example. And it also involves pi, pi to the fourth over 90. Shocking. I'm serious. Very shocking. Who would have ever guessed it? How can these involve pi? Where are the circles? Are there hidden circles in these problems? I forgot to share the 3 blue 1 brown video with you. I still need to do that. Are there hidden circles? There actually are hidden circles. You just can't see them. I think in the 3 blue 1 brown video explaining the original one, this one, I think there are some circles that come up in the explanation. If I recall correctly. You can relate these things to trig functions, it turns out. Would be another way circles come into play, since trig functions are related to the unit circle definition, at least is related to circles. It even works if it were like an 80th power down there. Look, there's a pi to the 80th in there. Why do I keep choosing even numbers? Because if you choose an odd number, it doesn't work so nice. Zeta of 3? What's zeta? That's just a function you've never heard of before. Surprise, surprise, new function. It's called the Riemann zeta function. I guess Riemann is the one who thought of it. Riemann zeta function. Yeah, there it is. Calling the input S instead of P. This definitely converges when S is a real number bigger than 1. It also turns out to make sense even for complex numbers. What? Complex numbers? This is a picture of the complex plane here. Real part of Z, imaginary part of Z. I don't want to explain that. It would take too long. Oh, look at that picture. Look at that, pretty pictures, if nothing else. And the Riemann zeta function, mysteriously, is related to prime numbers and the Riemann hypothesis. The Riemann hypothesis, I consider to be the most important, most famous unsolved problem in pure math. Nobody has ever solved it. If you solve it, you will win $1 million. It's a Millennium Prize problem for which solving it gives you $1 million. I'm serious. That's there. That's right. But of course, it's really hard because nobody's done it yet. People have tried. It does seem to be true. Its statement is very mysterious. Something about trivial, non-trivial zeros of the Riemann zeta function. I won't go into details. This mysterious unsolved problem in math, amazingly, is relevant for your life. Every day, in fact. What? How? Because it turns out to be relevant for the distribution of prime numbers in a mysterious way. And that turns out to be relevant for cryptography, secret codes. And cryptography turns out to be relevant for your internet work, transactions, financial transactions, logging into websites with your password. It's all in codes, secret codes, cryptography, and it's all, at least a lot of it, is based on the Riemann hypothesis being true. And nobody knows it's true. Actually, I'm not positive that it's completely based on the truth of the Riemann hypothesis, but we can pretend it's related, at least, because it's related to the distribution of prime numbers in ways that are, I won't go into because it's just too hard. But it's related to P series is the point. So it is related to calculus. All right, have a good day.